Thanks, Alia. Hello, everyone. Welcome to Fodan Africa and Asia webinar regular meeting. And today, I will moderate this meeting to replace Alia. And today's session will be discussed about the CEDAR FDP convergence and also update from access and control. And also the last session is about FAIR special journal update. And I will hand over to who will lead the discussion today. Is it you, Professor Francisca?
I think Professor Miriam is going to do that. She has a presentation. Okay. So I'll just like to welcome everyone and then say that I'm excited to announce that we have made tremendous progress and we have made some very exciting changes to the implementation of the program here. So I won't let the cat out of the bag yet. Professor Miriam will, in her usual way, take us through the changes and the plans for the phase two of the projects. Professor Miriam, please.
Okay, I will hand over to Professor Miriam.
Yeah, thank you, Professor Francesca. Thank you, Putu. And for Putu and Alia for organizing again. I just wanted to welcome a few new people who are joining us. First of all, I would like to request Dean Jamal from East Africa University. Welcome, Dean. It's great to have you here. And please introduce yourself to this group.
Thank you so much. Thanks, Prof. Mitchum. Thanks from Francisco. Thanks, Hadi. My name is Jamal Muhammad. I am from Somalia. I work here in Somalia. I'm a Dean of Medical and Health Science in Faculty of Dean of Medical Health Science in East Africa University. Thank you so much. It's my pleasure to have you here today. Thank you.
It's wonderful to have you, Dean. And I also wanted to ask Noor, who has joined us, to also introduce himself. Please take the floor, Noor. Noala.
Hello, everyone. I am Nurullah from Turkey Sabancı University, computer science and engineering student. I am glad to be here and to meet you. Thank you.
Thank you too. It's good to have you with your background in machine learning. And then Flavia, I think we should also introduce you. Flavia? We can't hear you, my dear.
Flavia, let me see. I'm trying to find her.
She's a FE.
FE, I think she's off.
Oh, she just left as a, okay. So Flavia, she is a, she came to us through Eric Schultes, and she has done a work on a verification of data early on in 2016. And she would be a real asset in the team of Dr. Miriam. So she has already for the last week been attending Vodan. And she really wants to engage with the FAIR data from a scientific perspective. Oluwole, please go ahead. I see your hand raised, please.
Sorry, it was an error. Sorry, please.
Oh, all right. Okay.
Oh, thank you.
No problem. All right. So then I think that was by way of introduction. And then I have a slideshow. First of all, I've made two slideshows for today. One is the timeline and planning and why we are really happy, Professor Francesca and I, is that we really can see now how everything is really in order and feasible. So we know where we are going. So today we'll discuss the parameters for that. And yeah, then of course we are very much interested to hear your feedback. But the purpose is that this really gives direction to all of us. And this is from both of us. We have been working really hard over the weekend. So this is our joint work. And then there is also a PowerPoint that I did on the issue of the forms that we use, which are going to be the key issue for the production of the data. So those are the two things that I would like to present to give everybody kind of a sense of where things are going, and also maybe a look at the slides in a way to see where you belong, you know, what is, because you can see how big the group has become. We are now here with 31 persons, sometimes we're even here with 40. So everybody has really different specialization and different things to offer. So it becomes increasingly important that that you are clear where you fit in the bigger jigsaw puzzle. And that is what we were trying to get some comfort around. So let me open up the slides here. So this is the presentation on our collaboration and put in the context of a timeline and deliverables. So yes, so this is us. This is what we all know here, that what we are developing is a flexible system that allows health professionals to access data needed for research and for clinical observations and to help steer within their health facility. And this system generates data that are machine readable, that are fair, and that can be accessed by anyone, but under very clearly controlled access criteria that are controlled by the facility itself and under the regulatory laws of the country where the data is generated. So that is what we do. That is our vision. So first of all, maybe to look into the key areas of work, we need to have overarching timelines. So the most important timeline is that we aim to have our minimal viable product ready by September. Then we have more detailed timelines towards that, which we will discuss. Then we need to be very clear on our general requirements and specifications. What are the key principles on the basis that we carry out this work, and what do we need for that? Then we need to be very aware of our implementing partners and the places where we are going to implement. And then we have the technical working groups, and I'm going to come back on that. But so there's the group of Mariam, which is producing the forms for the data, the machine readable data, based on the CDAR templates. And these will be developed for Ethiopia, Uganda, Zimbabwe, Kenya, Nigeria, but with the possibility of this also being perhaps done, as we are seeing now the possibilities in Liberia and perhaps also Somalia and Tanzania. Then Alia and also Dr. Sakinat are working with two groups that are creating vocabulary in relation to the forms that Mariam is doing. And these two processes are very, very key. So later on, we are also going to discuss that in a sense, the geographical teams should certainly make sure that they have expertise in this group one and two, because this is really what we will get out of this process, the ability to do this. And this is something that can be applied not only just in the context of our clinical data, but which becomes also very, very valuable in the context of the research data. Then the research data here is the group of Dr. Mariam, who are doing the same thing, but then in the context of research data. And that is a separate, completely separate parallel trajectory. Well, then the whole architectural integration and testing is, of course, the responsibility of Professor Francesca, together with Alia and with Samson Engetu, and also Tigist is part of that highly technical team. And they have started to make the whole inventory, and this is going very, very well. Putu is leading at this moment the access and control and the integration of the hospitals that will be participating. And this is, first of all, a very highly social task, really the communication, getting the right understanding in the health facilities. And Putu is working hard on that with the team. Again, it's really important that for all of the geographical teams, somebody is in that team of Putu. Then Yilin, but especially also in relation to the seventh one with Dr. Sakinat, and led by Dr. Sakinat, they will work on the dashboards for the clinics, which will be completely tailor-made for the clinic and only accessible in the clinic and under access and control decisions by the clinic. And so this back end, where we have the collaboration with data biology, will be led by Dr. Sakinat, and Yilin will be working particularly on assisting the understanding of what the clinics would like to integrate in their clinics dashboards. And then Rudwan will be working on the, well, the hosting element and the indexing of Google. And then we have the geographical teams, where we have the coordinators, Dr. Bernard from Zimbabwe, Great Zimbabwe University, Dr. Wondimu from Addis Ababa University of Ethiopia, Mariam, together with the help of the VC of Kampala International University in Uganda, Dr. Reginald in Kenya, Dr. Sakina together with Kau of Ibu in of the Nigeria team. And then, as we see in Liberia, Minister Julia Duncan Cassell, I spoke to her this morning. Wondimu has really been doing the legwork there, but she's very happy for Liberia to be included. And Dean Jamal is here from Somalia. And yeah, perhaps with Dr. Jeremia, also Tanzania as a possibility. So these will be the leaders of the geographical team. So that leads us to this very impressive organigram. I hope that it's big enough for you to see. But this, I will also distribute one slide, which is just on this organigram. But it's very important to look at this and consider this, and then also see where your responsibility is and where your strength is. So we're starting here with the geographical teams. Why? Because everything that we do is completely in function of what is desirable in each geography. So our geographical leads are the most important for the success of this project. So we can't really do anything without Dr. Wondimu, without Dr. Bernard. In Uganda, it would be Dr. Robinson and the VC, and of course, Mariam, Dr. Reginald, Dr. Sakinat, and also Kau. And then the other teams, if we consolidate those. And so the work of them with the technical teams, but also with the ministries of health and the facilities, the health facilities, is completely, completely critical. And so that is our first concern. Then the second concern is that everything that we do cannot duplicate what already is happening. So in Uganda, the health facilities report to DHIS Uganda. Mariam has a very good overview of how that exactly works and which information through the DHIS is sent. And so whatever we then do needs to respect these workflows within the clinics and between the clinics and the districts, as well as the Ministry of Health. So we don't do anything over and beyond what is already happening, but what we do is we create the machine readable backend to the data, and we create this strong structure of access and controls, which then also allows us to make the internal dashboard for each of the facility. So here we already start to see diversification. So for instance, in Zimbabwe, we have Impilo. So if in Zimbabwe they don't use the HIS tool, but they work Impilo, then we will work with Impilo. So we are really working from the ground up. That has to be the mindset of everyone. So then once we understand this part, then we have the technical team, of Mariam, who creates the forms in the machine readable format, and then where we need the new vocabulary for that, the teams of Aliyah and Sakinat are supporting Mariam. And then parallel to that, also important, the research data team of Dr. Mariam of Tunisia. Then the issues of access and control. We have, first of all, to understand the, you know, who is the data, the equivalent of the data controller in a given facility. What is the oversight of the Ministry of Health? What are the facilities authorized to do or not? We need to understand all of that. And then we also need to understand the relationship between, you know, the equivalent of what we could call a data controller and the data processor. The data processor could just be the person typing in the data for DHIS too. That is the processing of the pen and paper data into the computer, which we then propose to do in a machine readable format. They are sent to DHIS, but they also remain within the clinic and are available for the dashboard. And for the dashboard, we need to then also really understand the wishes, the wish list of that clinic, which needs to be authorized. So for that, we need to understand who is reporting to whom and where the final authority lies. So all of that work is what is being done by Putu. Eric Flickenshield is there because he looks at this from the side of the LUMC, and we try to understand how these can go together and come together. And then Tigist is here, but maybe for a little later in the process, to really see the IT translation of this. But at this point, first, we really need to get in touch with all of the clinics and understand how the clinics see this working for them. That's Putu's job. Then Yilin will need to do the same, but then on the dashboard. So they also need to work together closely, because we don't want to burden those who go to the clinics. And then the whole computational side of that is Dr. Sakina, together with Data Science Nigeria, and then the machine learning experts. They are strengthening this team. Then here, the integration and testing. This is also including Alia, who is integrating all of the architecture with CIDAR, and Professor Francesca, but Samson and Getu are very much looking at the requirements and specifications for the integration of the system. Oh, so that is why they were there. Sorry, I jumped. So that is why they're here. Then the CIDAR hosting on the internet, we'll leave that until later, but yesterday we had a very good session on that, and I think we are very clear on how we can do this in a very controlled way, much in the same way as the FAIR data points, but it would replace the FAIR data points, and then the indexing by Google, but again, very controlled. Then we have the whole element of the integration of the research data of Dr. Mariam, which she leads with the integration in CIDAR, the deployment, the dashboard that is specific for the COVID research data, and then the integration and testing in VODAN. And this within the context of the 61, I think, projects that are part of that from the funders on MVA, just to see how that would work and what that would add to us in VODAN. Then very important as well, I mean, all of these teams are very important, is the deployment team. This will be Francesca together with Sakinat, where Tigist will lead the deployment in Ethiopia, Mariam in Uganda, Kuda Kwashi in Zimbabwe. We think Ilaya and Toby in Nigeria, if we are right, William in Kenya, and then we'll identify also for the other countries. Then there is the capacity building and the training. So here again, Alia and Getu are very much involved already together with Francesca and Sakinat in the curriculum development that we have already been working on since November. And so we've done a lot of preparatory work for that. And then the coordination of the training will be with Alia. Then the communication, which is so incredibly important, that is Obina, and I can't say this enough, the success of what we do is in the careful and properly applied communication that we do, that should really be geared towards the health facilities. The most important success that we can have once we do the minimal viable product is this. I was speaking to, just give me one moment. I need to pause for a second. Misha. The most important thing that I felt became clear to me this week was when I was going over the process again with William from Pumwani Hospital in Kenya. And because every time I'm thinking, you know, am I really sure of the process? Do I understand it well? So, but William, you're here. So if I'm not correct in how I paraphrase it, you correct me. But you were explaining again something that I had heard already often from Mariam, and I've also seen, is that the way the tasks are carried out is that you have this cupboard where you have all the patient's forms sitting in paper, and then maybe once a week, somebody puts in all of this into the computer, then sends these data out and they go to the Ministry of Health, and nothing happens ever since or from that moment on with that data. And I mean, we have already identified the problem of the ownership of the data, but really the critical thing is that this data doesn't contribute in any way to the quality of care. And so that is really so important for the minimal viable product. If we can get feedback from the facilities that by organizing this dashboard that is just about the clinic itself, and where the clinic can actually make use of this data, then in my view, we have achieved the benchmark for the minimal viable product. So in everything that we do, we need to keep in mind that our ultimate goal is to improve the quality of healthcare within each facility. That should be what we obtain. And I'm putting it here under communication because that is what we should communicate. We should not come across as some group of crazy techies with the latest thing of innovation. I mean, I think that it is. And I think that this is going to be something that is maybe historic in terms of how the internet will develop. But it's not the point. The point for us is that we contribute to something that is meaningful within the facilities. And that is what we should communicate. So in this team of OBINA, the policy teams, the special events, and the board and steering committee meetings, they are critical for us to get this message across. And we should be very, very consistent in how we message this. And that should also be, incidentally, critical in what we do in the documentation. And that includes all the work that is led by Dr. Sagnat and Dr. Feng Hong on the special issue. And we have also asked Susan, who is the editor, to keep her eyes open for that message, to make sure that that message comes through all the time. And then all of that cannot be done without really, really good teamwork. And the one thing that I really appreciate so much is that right from the top, the leadership by Francesca and then all of those who support her and us, this teamwork is so critical. And I really so grateful for Frederick, who then translates all of that under the leadership of Francesca into supporting all of us in our needs for that. So then in terms of the general timeline, it means that now at this moment, we are completely focused on the preparation at the national level. So by the end of this month, we really need to have the country teams in shape. We need to know all the clinics that are writing up for this. We need to have our internal organization under control, which is what we are trying to do today. And external communication and approvals needs to be also initiated so that the ministries, the facilities, that they understand what they are signing up to. Then in April, the preparation at the clinic level, the in identifying the possibilities of deployment in the clinics, what their own assets are there, do they have computer servers, all of that, what are the information flows in the clinics, and the communication and preparation of the agreements with the clinics is what we'll need to do then. Then in May, the integration of the whole architecture. And we then as technical team should completely understand how we are going to carry this out, have identified the data stewards and have the agreement signed. And at that moment in May is also where we will be carrying out the training with all of the data stewards. And then from June and July, we start the implementation in the embeddable editor of the data production and start to see how that works. And then deploy the entire system to make it work and to start entering data, at least data for the minimal viable products. And then in August and September, we should have the dashboards both within the clinics and the Vodan one and test these so that then by the end of September, we have the data dashboards and we really have our minimal viable product, and that then we can pay attention to assess and evaluate how the health facilities have experienced this, what their thinking is, how we plan for greater sustainability, what issues have come up that need to be taken into account, the documentation and the communication, and the next steps. So from there on, we have a very detailed breakdown of timelines for this month, which means a full Vodan webinar meeting on the 30th of March, like today, where basically everybody attends, so that we can really see where we stand. Then the selection of all the clinics. So we basically need to have the lists complete on the 30th of March. We need to have the patient records form selected and translated these in CEDAR draft templates that which correspond to each clinic and to each country. And that needs to be at least ready so that we know whether it works, that we can test them, that we can test them offline, and that we then can plan for the finalization of that process in April. All of the communication should be available and translated, also translated into appropriate languages where that is necessary. And Putu needs to have worked with his team really on knowing how we will approach the discussions with the clinics in terms of their information flow and the key people in that and the key reporting structures for it. And then we plan at the end of April or May a series of events to celebrate 1 year of Vodan. And my proposal is to do that with the San Diego Center of Supercomputer, to go back to Christine because that was pretty nice. And then the hosting of CEDAR as an FDP, we also need to be clear what we are, how we are going to do that by the end of this month. So then in terms of specific, well, general requirements and specifications, we have these in terms of the data protection, data integrity, the data governance, and the total control within the clinic over access control and security. So all of this needs to be translated into specific work formats. And these are, this is basically a translation of what I said earlier. And all of you know these slides with the embeddable editor and the repository in residence, which then allows us to deliver to DHAS what is already common practice, and then have the dashboards. This is the same for the work of Mariam on the COVID-19 scientific data, and this could be the integration of those. And then our two partners for that is CEDAR for the controlled vocabulary and the arrangement so that it is findable, that we have the F of FAIR, but also under clearly defined conditions for accessibility, and data biology for the vocabulary production and also the computational support also for the backend. This is some information on data biology. They are a commercial company, but they are working with us without any, so as own their own contribution to us. There's no transfer of money from us to them, but we have agreed to collaborate up to the minimal viable product. And this shows their process. You see here, well, Eric, who introduced this, these are the two techies of them. Here you see Eric Flickenshield from LUMC and myself. This was one of our first meetings when Eric Schultes had asked for us to meet. And these can be completely localized in residence sources for each source, completely separated from all the rest and under separate access and control mechanisms. So the computing applications they have already built in, and their interest in working with us is to do this through the data visiting in residence. And this is something that they have not done before. They find it very interesting. And so that is why they have asked to work with us. We want to be absolutely secure that this doesn't take any capacity away from us. So we negotiated, Dr. Francesca and myself negotiated really hard, that we've said we have the data science Nigeria, we have, you know, we have excellent people in our team. So we don't want any dependency on any part of the architecture on data biology. And so they then offered that they are happy to fill in the parts of the jigsaw puzzle where we want them. So after this meeting, we have a meeting with them, with Dr. Sakinat and Professor Francesca. And so we'll stick to that. Dr. Sakinat handles this. And this is just really to see if and when we need them, they are available. But we are at the steering wheel of this. But also it is interesting for us because obviously it gives us also an insight in how they are approaching it, and we can also learn from that. So that is why we felt this was worthwhile. And they are, I mean, a nice bunch of people. So as long as we don't get distracted from what we want to do, it should also be beneficial to have collaboration across. So that is the end of this slideshow. And then I maybe just go on, it's maybe a bit long, but maybe I go on to go to the templates, because then I stop sharing and I reshare so that all that clarity is also there, and then we can have the discussion. So I share this. Sorry for the overload of information. So then on the templates. So there are two types of templates. So what I've called here the zero template, this is basically the metadata about the clinic. And the data production of the clinical data is here. And I've put here two, because the proposition is to have two templates here. So that means this one, which would be which basically would refer to each of the templates that is produced here. And both all of that is then being reposited here in residence, or whatever residence is decided by the health facility. And this is the same for Mariam. So this is the zero template, which is basically the metadata about the research project and the university. And then the research data for, well, each field that you want to make machine readable and number. You can create the templates in CIDAR here, and you can reposit them within the university or on CIDAR or anywhere else for that matter. And then this is the, again, the same system across. So the template zero provides the provenance data for the facility. And it gives us a unique identifier. It is related to access and control and provides contact information. So basically, template zero could be built in to every other one because you don't want to continue to do that for every other data point. But it is the belonging of the data point that is arranged in template zero. And then the other forms, and that of course needs to be made. So Mariam and team need to that needs to be a machine readable thing. And then the template, the forms that are basically the equivalent of the DHIS2 for the machine readable data production, but which is the same as what DHIS2 needs in that particular clinic. The purpose here is to make them a machine readable and from the clinic and in residence of the clinic to make them relate to the workflows, which is the DHIS2 based, if that is what the clinic does, or in Pelo or any other thing, if the clinic does something else, and where we really don't want to interrupt that workflow. So basically the standard is that no extra time is needed by the clinic to do this job. So they get training and they get data stewards that, you know, that are conversant with, more conversant with data science. They get the dashboard, but we are not asking more time from them, apart, of course, for their participation in the training, if they have somebody that they want from their team to participate, but that is voluntary, and perhaps some IT support, etc., for the deployments. So that is a very important criteria. No extra time, no doubling of entering of data, whatever. So it should be within the existing workflows. There are then two forms that are strongly, there's strong advocacy for two forms. And so the proposal is to have both forms available for all clinics if they so wish. The first one is the outpatients register, and Mariam is working on that. And the other one, these proposals come from our Ethiopia team, and we think it's a good proposal, is the form on maternal health and child care. I also think that it relates very well to the interest of the, Pumwani Hospital, but also the Philips startup project and so on. So we thought that this could actually be a good idea, but it's something that we need to discuss and that the country teams need to discuss. And there's always the possibility of just choosing one of these forms to work with for the minimal viable products. So again, all forms are adapted to the actual use in the clinic. So if there are differences of these two forms within clinics, then it's our job to adapt them. So there are still some outstanding questions there that in, for instance, the form that I looked at in Uganda, it has personal data, which apparently are actually transferred to the Ministry of Health. So we need to compare this across the different countries. And it's actually not in conformity with our own framework, which follows GDPR. So this is something that we need to have some further discussion on, and which should also be a discussion with the facilities and the Ministries of Health. I don't know what we should do. But at the end of the day, if we're saying these data need to go to DHIS2 and that is working practice and that is the standard then we use, then I suppose it can be done, but they can absolutely not be made accessible for any of the operations in Vodan. So there are still issues to sort out, but the limits of these, limitations are clear. We are not going to create interoperable data that are not completely depersonalized and completely free of any personal information. So the clinics to be included, the proposal at the moment, but it's even shifting every moment of the day, but we will want to consolidate this now in the coming week, is the best consolidated is Ethiopia with 20 facilities selected and complete agreement within the country team. So this is done. Then in Zimbabwe, we have actually, we are proposing to limit the number because we feel that it might be still might be facing some issues, maybe can be more. We'll like to hear from the Zimbabwe team on this, but we need to have a consolidated list. As I say, the deadline is really the 30th of March. Nigeria, Ibul has offered that they can work with 20 facilities. So again, this needs to also then be agreed in between all of us, but it could be a very good proposal. Kenya, I think if I'm right, but I'm not sure, I need to get an update from Dr. Reginald that the current status is 2. Uganda, I think approximately 6, but it's not consolidated. Tanzania 1, if Dr. Jeremiah agrees on the offer to be included. Liberia 1, as per the proposal generated by Wandimu. And then perhaps with Dean Jamal here, also Somalia. The total required for us is 50. So that is our benchmark. So on the teams for the production, this is a repetition of before, but what is important is that the team of the form production preferably should include members of all the country teams so that all of the countries have their own independent experts who can do this and that the facilities are never left alone, that they are always able to have an expert, if something needs to be changed or whatever, who can do this and then can also rely on the technical team to assist if something is more complicated. So the request to the country teams is to identify a member for Mariam's team. So the timeline here then is the collection of all the forms in each country and if there are differences between clinics for all the clinics. As soon as possible, I've put it here in the coming days. The draft version of the Ugandan outpatient register to be really ready for discussion on the 29th of March, but for the discussion on 27th with John. The improved version on the outpatient register ready for 5th of April. All country outpatient forms ready for the country teams by the 12th of April. And then the same for the 19th of April. So it's also important that we get more people on this to really keep this timeline. And it's a big effort for Mariam to coordinate this and to really make sure that this is done, because this is a critical issue that then for the training, we have the tools to work with in May. The technical team to work on the localization aspect, there's a lot of detail to that. And we'll be discussing this. We had a long discussion on it yesterday, and Professor Francesca is very much on top of this together with this really great team. So that's all in hands. The testing of all the forms, again, the deadline is the 29th of April, at least for the ones of the outpatients. So, and with that, I'm at the end of the slideshow. I'm sorry to have taken so much time, but I thought it would be good to really get a general overview and for all of us to be on the same page. So Putu, open for questions and any comments now. And thank you for your attention, really. And definitely we will share all the material immediately afterwards. Putu has it.
Yes, is there any questions or comment?
Actually, I think it would be a good time for the country teams to ask questions for clarifications on what they need, because now it's going into their hands, and apart from the Ethiopia and Uganda, the other country teams. I apologize for the noise. Some workmen are working, trying to restore electricity for me. So apart from Ethiopia and Uganda, we don't have a clear list of hospitals yet. I know Kenya tomorrow, Dr. Reginald already has a list, a preliminary list of two, and then we're meeting tomorrow to finalize at country level. And we're going to be having some sub-meetings at country level, like we have been meeting with Ethiopia to finalize the hospitals and some of the logistic details. We're going to be doing the same thing for Kenya, for Nigeria, for Tanzania, for Liberia, and the other country team. So it will be a good time for the country leads or any member of the country teams to ask specific questions now, especially now that we have presented the next steps. We need to have the list of hospitals for those other, the other countries. And then also we need to know the process of approaching the hospitals and the permissions and then all the communications that we need to do. It is now going local, like a local politics. They have to do a lot of leg work, right? Just like Dr. Wundimu has done in Ethiopia and Dr. Reginald has done in Kenya. And of course, Mariam and the VC have been doing in Uganda. So Nigeria, where are you? Dr. Sakinat, Dr. Ibrahim, and the Malam Kawu, and of course, Data Science Nigeria.
Perhaps we can ask Dr. Wundimu, if he's here, we have so many today, to give an introduction of how his team is set up, because I think that gives us a very good idea of what makes a really good country team. But I also see the hand of Dr. Abdullahi. Maybe first Dr. Abdullahi and then Win Wundimu, if that's possible, or somebody from the Ethiopia team. Dr. Abdullahi, please go ahead.
Yes.
Mariam, thank you so much for having me. Right here in Nigeria, we have been in talk with lots of the hospitals, and particularly the crisis or the, yeah, the crisis managers, they call them. And we've been doing so many documentations and showing them the acceptability and the need to go into VODAN and into accepting fair data ideologies. So we will liaise the other partners in Nigeria, particularly Dr. Sakinat and our own lead director, Prof. Francisca, and we will revert back as soon as possible. Thank you so much.
That is excellent news. And I'm really also so pleased to hear that it is really within those conversations that a lot of things get clearer. And I think that is just really a critical part of the your work. So thank you so much, Dr. Abdullahi. Wundimu, I can see you have the mic on.
Please. Oh, thank you. Good afternoon again. Thank you very much. Maybe just to give an overview about Ethiopia. What we have tried to do is just we try to link with existing project. We do have a health information system capacity building and mentorship project, which is supported by the Ministry of Health. So we have the project team, so we link with them, and also we have a university hospital, and also we are planning also to select to identify focal person from each health facilities. And as well, in addition to this, the policy people is very important. So from the Ministry of Health, we are engaging the policy plan directorate director and also health information infrastructure director. We do have a two, policy and also the infrastructure. So we will select two expertise, the management from management member from the Ministry of Health, and also we are planning also to identify one regional health bureau representative, because region is autonomous by themselves. So we have, you know, the university academician and also the policy maker, as well implementer from the health facility. So it includes all stakeholders. So this is the way that we have planning to start the implementation. So besides this, we are also trying to review every week, you know, the progress within a team. And also we when we have, we do have a question, we will bring it to Professor Miriam and Professor Francisca in order to resolve with some of the issues. Thank you, Prof.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you, Dr. Ondimo. And one thing that is also very particular about your team is that you have Ephraim and Atkuchu to work specifically with all of the clinics, and which will be a very important liaison for Putu. So I think that is something that is also could be very good if other teams also have this intermediary people who can go back and forth with the clinics, especially if the numbers are a bit large, that will become quite important. So I really appreciate that from the way you've set it up, Dr. Mondimo. Then maybe Dr. Reginald, do you want to speak about your team and what you have heard and if this fits with what your thinking is?
Yeah, thank you, Professor. It fits in very well because we are trying to explore these questions and discuss with the relevant means of health officials so that when we meet the relevant bodies, we have a clear model to share with them. So it fits in very well with our thinking. Thank you.
And the number of clinics as well, Dr. Reginald?
Because accessing government-run hospital will be a bit of a challenge, we want to do a demo with the two private hospitals, then we see how we scale it up. Some of the doctors work with the government. I think if the model is right, they're able to bring us to the Ministry of Health. Then from there, we are able to showcase what we are trying to do.
Excellent. I don't know if Zimbabwe, Kudakweshi, Golden, anyone can speak and comment on the presentation. If not, then we go to Mariam for Uganda.
So with the Ugandan team, currently we have two hospitals on board, but I'm going to be working with the VC to identify a few more hospitals. So,
Good. And perhaps also look at the whole sort of division of responsibilities in the team so that we have different people attached to different processes. That'd be great, Mariam. Okay.
I just wanted to add that the way we have set up the teams, the vocabularies, and then the template teams, we make sure that each country has a representative. Yeah. In fact, it has a lot of burden on William because William is the only data steward from Kenya. So he has to be in both teams. Then Dr. Reginald, who prefers to be in the research data, is with Dr. Mariam. So if you can get more data stewards from Kenya, that will also be nice because it's just him. And then sometimes when they have their meetings at the same time, I wonder how he's able to attend the two meetings at the same time.
Yeah, so we have to strengthen the teams with representatives of all countries because we cannot communicate unless we have people who can understand and explain the technical, unless you understand what we mean when it is safe, protected, secure, it's difficult to convey that message. I think that is also why Ibul has been very successful because they really understand. So then you can also communicate. So that is why we need from every country somebody on board. Let me then go to Tunisia, Dr. Mariam.
Hi, Professor. Hi, everyone.
Hi.
So in our case, we are more interested by research data. So we are working in outpatient data, especially for migrants. And we are now working in the creation of vocabularies and and introducing this new vocabulary on BioPortal. So we will join the ZoneMVEI project for this implementation part.
Great. Then Dean Jamal, it was your first time here. So what is your impression? I've seen you very active in the chat. Thank you for that.
Thanks so much, Prof. Actually, I'm very happy to be with you here today. And I just I get the idea how this project will be look like. And really, I'm part of the Minister of Health and do understand how the what the point that you are talking about. And I really appreciate, and last night we were talking about how we can be create a system for hospitals. I do support for 3 hospitals. And there's a project that is we work with, we have a link with international NGO called Save the Children International. And also we have a link with WHO and UNICEF. And also we directly work with health facilities. I personally supported for the 57 health facilities. And I do provide on-job training. And we also we do quarterly data audit for the to ensure the quality of the data. So I have we use a DHS tool. We already implementing, and right now we are in place to use all our system is in DHS tool, and we retrieve the data from the DHS tool. So I have thanks so much, and I think I will just I will look. I need to look the indicators that we want to just maybe I will look. I need to look at the project in the proposal and how I will even you will share with the document. But what I'm telling you is that we are in good position and we can work with you. I right now I can if you can tell me the number of health facilities that we need. Okay, there's no we have no problem with that, and we do support. We provide daily support for the health facilities. So it's very easy for me to identify health facilities, but we need to agree some criteria, what kind of health facilities are we going to select. For us in Somalia, there's a 4 referrals, there's a referral health centers, there's a district, we call it district hospital, and there's a regional hospital, and there's a health centers. So if we agree the nature of the health facilities, that is easy for me to back up. And also for the health workers, we have very good relation with hospital, and we can explain and we should cause our case for them. And they are very ready. And there's a hospital that is supported by the MSF, which is a very good hospital. We can, and if so, just we want to understand what kind of health hospital that we need, and then it's easy for me to make a team and select, identify health facilities for the project. Thanks so much.
Excellent, excellent. You'll be discussing this in the coming days, Dean, and very, very glad to hear all of that. Let me also ask Dr. Araya, who is working on digital health, how you're looking at the presentation. Dr. Araya.
Yeah, thank you, Miriam, and good afternoon all. I'm happy with all the progress, and the presentation is informative. I was not attending for the past 2 or 3 weeks because I was back in Maghala where there is no internet connection, but I have been getting updates from Samsung and Gaitu. I'm very happy to see the involvement and the contribution of Samsung and Gaitu as colleagues. Very encouraged with that. But I would like to congratulate all team members, the leadership, for all the progress and the clarity of the ideas, the roles and responsibility of each team member. And very happy to hear also the plan for Ethiopia and the leadership from Wendemo to Gist. And if there is anything that we can contribute, we are very happy to work with Addis Ababa University team. Where me, Samson, and Gaitu, we will be in Addis Ababa for 2 weeks. So we would be very happy to meet the Addis Ababa team in person so that we can discuss and look for any support and collaboration we can make in the work. Thank you.
very grateful, Dr. Raya, for those words. And then maybe before we close, let me give the floor to Dr. Sakinat also for the for a response and for an update on the special issue. I can see it is 10 past three, so it's time to close soon, but not before we have an update from our Dr. Sakinat. Doctor, please.
Yes, thank you, Professor Miriam. I think the presentation was excellent, and I believe that we are going to live up to the task. For the special issue update, I actually would like to call on Misha to give us the latest update, because we work on it even up to the hour that we are meeting on Budan. Please, if you permit me to call Misha. Misha? Yes, hello, Misha. Even on the chat, we have the link to the Excel sheet that we have the summary of what we have been doing so far, the people that have submitted, the edits, and the...
Can you hear me?
The... Yes, Misha, we can hear you.
Okay, so...
Welcome.
I posted the link in the chat. Can I share the screen again?
Aliyah can make you co-host, so you can share your screen, or maybe I just enable screen sharing for everyone. Oh, okay.
So we have made a big advancement this week again. We went through all the articles that were sent in and we reviewed them, and we've either sent them to Susan, so three of them were sent to Susan for review, and one has already come back, and then the rest we send them back for small edits, but many of them were in the very last stages. There are very few that still need significant changes before we can send them on. So we expect probably two or three more to be ready soon that we can send, and which really shows that all the green is all the green in the sheet is what has been sent to Susan and what is being worked on, and you can really see that well, it's starting to take over the whole sheet, so it shows that there's a lot of progress has been made. And there are very few articles that remain outstanding, which is also good. There's also one new article that was added and that's being worked on. It's not in the process of being finalized yet, but it's a new article, which is good. And so you might be interested in that. The abstract is online if anyone wants to read it about what it is. Any questions?
I have a question. Sorry.
Yes.
What does TBR mean?
Oh, TBR means that it needs to be that it has been sent in to us, and that Miriam, Professor von Reisen, will look at it. Okay. And send it back. It's just the TBRs. This one is wrong, but just the TBRs is for me to know which ones I have. It's for me. The status is mostly for me to follow it and know approximately where the article stands. And if a follow up needs to happen with the person, then I know what to do. But it's not really very significant. It just means that it needs to be reviewed by Miriam. Anything else?
Yeah, thank you, Misha. I just want to congratulate on that. The Google sheet is taking shape now. The green is gradually taking over.
Right. Great. Well, I'll stop. Thank you very much for all the hard work. I think everyone is doing very well.
Thank you, Michelle. I just want to remind Professor Miriam and Dr. Sakina that the meeting with Data Biology is actually starting in like less than 1 minute.
Okay, thanks, Michelle, for your update. Is there any question or comment? Because now it's... because if it's not, I will close the session. So thanks everyone for the participation for today's meeting. So recording of this meeting will be available in every channels in YouTube, Slack, and also in WhatsApp group. Thanks for joining us in this meeting, and see you next week. Bye.